Hey everyone, my name is Chris, and welcome back to the Rideshare Hub. If you're new here, Rideshare Hub is a channel all about being a better rideshare driver and making some money. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you for coming back. Before we get into the video, if you're interested in becoming a Lyft or Uber driver and you want to get a sign-on bonus, use the links in the description below to sign up. Alright, so this video is 10 tips that you can do to make better tips driving for Uber or Lyft in 2019. So I wanted to say a quick disclaimer, tips are not guaranteed. You could go above and beyond in your service and not get a tip, or you could just give no service and get a tip. It really depends, but if you follow these few tips, you're definitely going to have a better chance at getting more tips in 2019. So first few tips I'm going to give you actually start before the ride even happens. Number one, make sure your car is clean, no odors. Make sure your car is maintained. Biggest thing is you don't want to pull up to a ride where your brakes are screeching or your car is real dirty or anything like that. You want to make sure your car is clean. Same thing with the interior. Make sure it's clean so people are able to get in and out easy. Nothing's falling over. It's going to be really good that way. Also, no odors. That's going to throw people off right away. Number two, look good. Wear nicer clothes. Don't just wear like a comfort hoodie and sweatpants. Put on a pair of jeans, put on a nice shirt, hoodie, like a nicer hoodie, or a jacket. You could even put on, a suit and tie, if you really want to do it that way too. Chances are you're going to get better tips when you look nicer and you look better. You want to take a shower and you want to smell neutral. So no odors and no perfumes. You really want to smell neutral because, well, one, nobody likes odor. And two, if somebody's like allergic to perfumes or cologne or anything like that, it's just going to be a throw off as well. So just smell neutral, keep it clean, and dress nice. And those are a couple of things that you can do before the ride even begins. So now let's talk about a few things that you can do while the ride is actually happening, and we'll get right into that. So number three is when the ride begins, greet them by using their name. Ask other passengers that come in as well what their name is. Say yours. You want to make it really personal, like a nice personal interaction. They're in your car, so it's they're very close. It's within person's intimate space. So, and plus everything's confined, so all the talking and everything is right there. So definitely ask them their name if you don't know it. Or also one of the big things too is if they use like this little code name, which isn't their actual name, ask what their real name is. Because like I say, you make that personal interaction. Another quick little tip is ask them about how they got that little name. That can just show an interest. And it's also going to help you know if they want to talk or not. So let's go to number four. Ask them also how they're doing. It's a simple question, but it's really going to give you a read on how they are, how they're feeling. If there's a problem, if they need to vent, they're going to start venting. If they're not going to want to talk, they're not going to want to talk. So it's really going to give you a good ice-breaking question on how they're doing and kind of go from there on how you want to proceed too. So number five is pay attention to the passenger and match them. So like I say, if they want to talk or not, you'll be able to pick that up with asking how they're doing. So if they don't want to talk, they pull out their earbuds, just drive, let them just enjoy the ride and just don't talk and just enjoy. So number six, if they do want to talk, ask questions. Take an interest on what they're saying. Share some experiences. And you never know who you're really going to come across. A couple of people that I've taken before, I took the Bills offensive line coach, and we were talking about how we thought the Bills were actually doing versus what their expectation was. And it was just this really raw conversation that we had that was very kind of intimate. And if it didn't have that few ice-breaking questions and figure out if you wanted to chat or not. You know, it didn't lead into that type of conversation. Also, secondly, was a really cool person that I took, which was Janet Jackson's drummer. I took him from the Guitar Center to his hotel, and we just had a pretty cool conversation about what he was doing on the road and other acts that he's been part of and other people he's been with. And it was just a really cool experience to be able to talk to somebody like that. And if you don't ask those questions and engage them and take interest, you never know what could happen. Same thing with people all around the world. I talk to people all over the place. So it's really cool to take an interest. And it's also going to, again, make it personal to them. So they're going to be more apt to tip you. Number seven, if it's a longer ride or with a group of people, ask them if they want to listen to music, what type of music. And if they do, change the music when you're stopped. Just as a little tip, just for safety. But again, you know, they're going to be thinking safety in mind, so keep safe. But yeah, ask them in the music, and if they even want to listen to music. Sometimes people just don't want the music on, so they'll shut it right off, or they just don't care whatever is on is playing. But yeah, ask them that way. Again, you're taking what they want into account, so it's definitely going to be good. Number eight, when you're driving during acceleration, when you slow down a stop, or when you're taking turns, do it slower. You want to keep comfort and safety in mind. A lot of the times people, they want to be more comfortable. That's why they use these services over, you know, something like cabs. They want more comfort. They want that extra safety step because they know it's actual vehicles that people use. So it's a really good thing to do that. And just take things slower. When you're going at speed, you know you're at speed. That's no big deal. But, you know, allow extra time to slow down. Allow extra time to speed up. Take turns a little bit slower. Just keep their comfort in mind. And I don't mean like grandma slow. I mean like just a normal little bit slower so they're not like going back and forth. Number nine, make your car stand out. Make you as yourself stand out, but also make your car stand out. I've been around a few people while I'm driving where they'll talk about another Uber or Lyft experience that they've had where they've had something in their vehicle that really stood out to them. So make something in your vehicle really stand out. There's a few things I have in my vehicle that I've come across through either just different means and said, oh, that would be pretty cool to put in my car for rideshare. And that's basically what happened. And so I've helped make my car stand out by doing little subtle things, but really can have an impact on what passengers see and what they think and feel. And it just elevates them into something. And number 10, one of the easiest things, and it's the most important thing, smile. You know, flash them pearly whites at people. You know, a smile can go a long way and it'll elevate their mood. You know, if they're in a bad mood, if they're not happy, you know, a simple smile can really engage them and make them feel better. You know, they could have been having a really bad day. Maybe they're having a really good day and another smile is just going to add to it. But definitely, definitely smile. Those are very important to do that. And it's infectious too. You know, if you smile at them, they're going to smile back. And again, it's going to release the endorphins and it's going to make them feel better. So that's always a good thing. All right. So those are 10 tips that you can do to greatly improve your chances of getting a tip or better tips. So drivers out there, what are some things that you do as a driver that helps you get more tips? And any passengers who are watching this, what types of things do you look for that will make you tip better? Comment below because we love to know. Thank you everyone for watching. Again, if you're interested in becoming a Lyft or Uber driver, use the links in the description below and make sure to subscribe if you want to see more videos like this one. Also, check out my channel, Real Rideshare Stories, where we show actual rideshare rides. And this has been another episode of the Rideshare Hub. See you next time.